Are you planning on a trip to Iceland? Are you wondering what the tipping culture is like here? Whom to tip, how much to tip, when to tip? I've got you covered. Here is my top tip on tipping in Iceland. Ready? While in Iceland, please do not tip. It's as simple as that. So if you're in a rush, that's pretty much it. Thanks for watching. If not, please stick around for a couple of more minutes and I'll go into some explanations and some background. This really is a favorite location of mine. It's an abandoned farmhouse here in the Reykjanes Peninsula. There was a fire and I think actually there was anthrax here. So I think it burned down after it was evacuated due to an anthrax outbreak. Anyway, talking about tipping in Iceland. And all these things are gonna be, you know, my personal views on it. I may earn myself some enemies in the tourism industry here in Iceland, but we're just gonna have to deal with that. First off, tipping really isn't a part of the culture here. It's beginning to creep in, again, due to tourism. So we're seeing tip jars popping up in bars and cafes, and some tour guides might be suggesting or encouraging people to leave a tip. I want to counter that by encouraging you to please do not indulge them. Please help us safeguard the non-tipping culture. And why do I say that? Well, I think, well, there's actually, talking about tour guides, there's a tour bus driving just by. Anyway, so why? There are two real reasons. I think they're economic and or socio-economic and cultural in my mind. Economically, to begin with, Icelandic economy, the Icelandic work market, the job market, it should work in such a way that everybody is guaranteed a basic sustainable income. It's another question whether that's actually happening, and we can go into long debates on salary and salary levels and buying power or purchasing power of the salary and all that. But conceptually, fundamentally, everybody in Iceland should be guaranteed a living wage. So everything is already baked into the price of the product that you are buying. And it becomes very difficult to have any kind of a meaningful conversation or discussion about salary levels, trying to campaign to sustain or grow the standard of the minimum wage in Iceland, if you add that level of obfuscation on top. If you have a level of or layer of secondary income, which is very hard to measure, very hard to gauge, then first off, we're no longer comparing apples and apples when we're trying to have a conversation on social reform and how to make sure that salaries are paid out fairly. Secondarily, you basically create this kind of shield which the employers then can hide behind, stating that, yeah, but you know, I don't have to pay so and so much because a part of people's income is covered by tips. We've never had this in Iceland, and I really don't want to go down the slippery slope where this starts to become a problem. So let's just make sure that people are guaranteed a good basic wage, a solid livable salary from their wages, and not introduce tipping. And keeping that in mind, that people should already be getting a decent wage, if you want to show your appreciation, there are other more human ways to do that than to throw money at them. Smile, say thank you. And then there is that cultural angle. Like I mentioned before, we are already being paid to do a particular job. So it feels a little bit awkward, it feels a little bit condescending sometimes to be paid extra to have actually done your job properly. It feels almost as if, you know, my honor is being insulted. We've already agreed upon a price. Please don't, you know, pay me extra as if you were surprised that I actually did what I already promised to do. So please don't be completely surprised if anybody is actually a little bit offended by being offered a tip in Iceland. All right, these are my quick rationalizations behind the statement, do not tip in Iceland. Please do not tip in Iceland. If you're indeed planning a trip here, I certainly hope you enjoy it and won't tip. You're free to do whatever you want, of course. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.